What do you wear to bed? You wear a pajama top. The bottoms of the pajamas are a nightgown. So I say Chanel number 5. Because it's the truth.
Sorry, Marilyn, but today we're not talking about number 5. Let's talk about les exclusives. Bonjour, bonjour, fragrance lovers. Welcome back to my channel. I'm gonna present you all Chanel Les Exclusives range. Know what is Les Exclusives? This is the private line of Chanel. So this is a line that is only sold in boutiques, specific area where they have exclusivity of fragrance. So you do have the classics and you do have Les Exclusives and you also have Les Eaux. Les Exclusives are very unique fragrances with really raw ingredients that are really connected to Chanel heritage. So each of them have a little Chanel story. I'm gonna show you how it's organized, which one is the best for you, with a simple explanation on each of them and a little story as well. After this video, you will know which fragrance is made for you. The fresher to the darker scent. For the presentation of the ingredient, just to let you know, I took the official ingredient list. All right, let's start. Let's start by the freshies, the lighter fragrance, good for summer when you want to feel clean. The cleanest one and the freshest one of the range is called Eau de Cologne. This is classic, this is timeless, this is the iconic Eau de Cologne that you expected. If you remember the vintage Eau de Cologne, definitely in this one you can feel that. However, it's quite modern, so you have a mix of citrus, neroli, mandarin and bergamot to refresh you after the shower, a hot day. So if you want something classic that is ultra refreshing and sparkling, this is so beautiful, and that's the freshest of all. In the French, now we're talking about the aromatics. So what is an aromatic? An aromatic is mainly with herbaceous tone, aromatic garden, rosemary, lavender, basil. Usually it's quite soothing but stays very fresh. The first one is Belle Respiro, so one of the freshest of the list. But really, if you want something quite aromatic, just like you're walking into a fresh garden with a sparkling luminosity, with a light breeze in your hair, green grass type of smell, you have a touch of galbanum, so it smells slightly green, a bit of rosemary, so slightly minty and uplifting. And this is really like your countryside but in a very classy way. It's not too green, which is lovely. One of my favorites, Belle Respiro, was actually the name of the house of Coco Chanel next to Paris in Garches, and this is where she used to relax in the countryside of Paris. The house was really the idea of serenity but in classiness, because she was still in the city. Next one is an aromatic again, but I would say maybe a bit more spicier, and this is Boy, most unisex of the whole list. Coco Chanel was really pro freedom for the ladies, and removing the corset, removing everything that was too ladylike. She wanted something clothes that were comfortable, the equal of the men's. And Boy is really what it is. It's a unisex fragrance with a lot of lavender, so quite relaxing, geranium, so it smells minty and uplifting green and a bit spicier, woody notes, so easy to wear for the two gender, and you can't categorize it. Boy also, because it's iconic for the house of Chanel. Boy was the love of her life, and when I smell Boy, I can really smell a bit of a love story. You can, even if it's spicy and uplifting, it's still cuddling and very classy. This one in the aromatic is a Jersey. Jersey is called like that because of the Jersey material that was before only used for men. Chanel took it in the 20s and made it for ladies. It was a very comfortable outfit for ladies, so it made a huge revolution in the fashion. Like the material, Jersey smell ultra comfortable. It's a creamy fragrance with a lot of lavender, but it's more like a, compared to boy, a creamy lavender. Huge amount of bourbon vanilla to increase the contrast between freshness and cuddles. A touch of Westmoss, so it's quite powdery, it's quite round. It's not something that is sharp at all. It's really just comforting. Freedom of movement with a touch of relaxing tone. Personally, when I smell that, I feel on holiday. This category of fragrance is the musky fragrance. So just to clarify, musky, especially in Chanel, is usually white musk, and white musk smells clean, cottony, a bit powdery, and slightly candied. First one is 1957, and it's actually the first true musky fragrance of Chanel from last year. Why 1957? Is because it was Coco Chanel opened her first store in New York, so it was really to showcase a bit the relation with Chanel and the USA. Her country kind of adoption after what happened. Story short, she created the Tweed collection, which revolutionized the fashion. But in France, people were mocking her and saying she was too old to create fashion. She took that collection, go to the US, and in the US, they told her that it was amazing. She was everywhere, and at the age of 70s, she was the queen. That's why I think the USA is such an important part for Chanel, because without them, what would we have done? French are so annoying. So it's three layers of white musk, so very cottony, fluffy, cottony-like and clean. And you've got bergamot to uplift the fragrance, so it's not heavy at all. It's so easy to wear if you want something quite light but long-lasting. Creamy undertone with sandalwood, touch of iris to make it a bit more earthy and powdery, and you get something that is really unique. I personally adore this scent. For daytime, it's one of the most easiest fragrance I like to spray. It's a casual chic outfit. Number 18 is the next one. This one is a bit like an alien in orange, I have to tell you. Musky tone, that's why I've put it with the musky. The ambrette, and ambrette smells slightly very, very soapy. A bit like a berry undertone. It's an ode to 18 Place Vendôme, which was the jewelry store. So it's supposed to smell like a diamond. It smells a bit metallic. So even though if I give you the ingredient, which are geranium, ambrette seed, it won't help you. It smells slightly metallic, it's quite heavy, and it smells like a precious gem, really reflecting a lot of light. But you have to smell it before. You need the good personality to wear it, because it's quite heavy as well. Let's go to the florals. And let's start with Gardenia. Gardenia is a nectar fragrance. It's a huge bouquet of white flower. It's called Gardenia because the camellia is the emblem flower of Chanel. The love of her life, both used to wear it on the pocket of his suit. Camellia is an emblem since, symbol of purity and royalty. But unfortunately, camellia doesn't have a smell, so she created a Gardenia accord, which is also a white flower, to represent that flower. Did you get it? Juicy, flowery tone. Usually a lot of people use it for their wedding because it smells purity, and it's really like a fresh bouquet of flower. It's born in 1925, so technically created by Ernest Beaux and Coco Chanel themselves, so it's part of the original collection of Les Exclusives. Next one, we have Beige. Beige is also a delicate flower scent. However, with this one, you've got a lot of orphan flowers, so white delicate flower, but you have a touch of honey, so it smells very clean. It's enhanced by your honey scent. Beige is usually one of the best sellers. It's usually the one that is suiting a lot of ladies, ultra classy, and it really represents the color beige. Beige was one of the favorite color of Mademoiselle and one of the emblem color of the house. It reminded her the sand of the beach of Deauville and Biarritz, where she created her first stores, and she used to have Little Wonder by the sea. Simplicity, and for Chanel, simplicity is elegance. You got Frangipani as well, so it's really nice, a bit sunny fragrance and easy to wear. The next floral scent is number 22. So this is technically an intense floral fragrance, the first exclusive launch ever. 1 year after number 5 in 1922, Ernest Beau gave 24 choice of sample for her to choose. She picked number 5, a lucky number, and she picked number 22. 22 is double amount of idea that number 5, so it's an explosion of fizziness, of champagne-like fragrance. Think of champagne, it's as bubbly as champagne, and you get a lot of creamy tuberose, but not the creamy that you're used to because it's a vintage fragrance. So you've got an explosion of ingredients which make it ultra seductive, charismatic floral. You need to have a good character to wear it and enjoy also a vintage fragrance. That's why it's my signature scent. Floral, we go to the fruity floral, and the only fruity floral of the collection is called 1932, mixes a balance of fruit with a lot of grapefruit and pear, flowery side of the jasmine. More heavy than the other florals because it's got a very intense powdery side. It's a bomb of powder, it's really projecting, and usually this fragrance gets me a lot of compliments because it's bright but also very seductive, sensual, charming and opulent. That could be really nice with a touch of freshness, and it's this contrast between luminosity and darkness is to symbolize the launch in 1932 of the Bijoux de Diamant collection. That was a collection of jewelry, and it was the first time when a designer created a line of jewelry, so that's why we called it 1932. Floral scent is La Posa. La Posa was another house of Coco Chanel in the south of France, so much more sunnier, but also having that dryness, because in the south of France it's a bit more drier because it's much more sunny. Powdery fragrance with the star ingredient of Chanel, which is Iris pallida, so slightly violet-like scent, but smells very earthy, really powdery and groundy, and you've got a lot of pink pepper, so it's very tickling your nose at the beginning with a yummy and vibrant tone. Again, but you really need to love the iris powderiness. Next category is the chypre. One of the only chypre of the House of Chanel with Pour Monsieur is 31 rue Cambon, 31 rue Cambon, address of the main store of Chanel in Paris, and this is where Coco Chanel used to live. She really smells couture. It's a haute couture scent. It's smelling like textile refined. And what's a chypre fragrance? A chypre fragrance got citrus top notes, so quite acidic. And then you've got cistus labdanum, so slightly leathery tone. And then you've got a mossy base, quite green. Tiver and a lot of iris again, but really, all of this mix of ingredients make it like very refined and also quite unisex, which is quite nice. And when I smell it, I always remember of the store, it's beautiful. So if you're looking for something unique, classy, you will enjoy. Category that is the woody fragrance. So woody fragrance, we have Sycamore, which is one of my favorite vetiver fragrance. Why is it called Sycamore? Is because personality of Coco Mademoiselle. The Sycamore tree is one of the biggest. It symbolizes the strength of character of Mrs. Gabrielle Chanel. You can smell a lot of vetiver. It smells nearly like a burning wooden vetiver tone, very earthy. If you love vetiver fragrance, you're gonna absolutely adore this one. Tobacco, so the tobacco gives a smoky aspect to it, so quite smoky fragrance overall. It's perfect for fall, made in the Chanel DNA, which is classy and elegant, so it's not too heavy. It always have like a brighter undertone to uplift the fragrance. It won't be something too dark. Is Bois des Îles, so Bois des Îles is the exotism wood in the island, so a lot of spices, very sensual and creamy tone with a lot of tonkebin. So if you like this vanilla like scent, and it also uplifted by a yellow flower that always smells very solar and exotic, and it's ylang ylang, so it's cloudy, I would say a cloudy fragrance, but ultra sensual, vintage as well. One of the first fragrance still created by Nesbo and Coco Chanel, so it's vintage, and it was also first woody scent created for ladies. Definitely it's unisex, 100%. This category, and with a single fragrance inside, is the Levenoise. And we have Cuir de Russie. It's a lot of bush store. So it smells like you polishing the shoe of the soldier, but with a touch of jasmine. So it's a leather that is balanced down with a touch of floral, so it won't be too dark, too plasticky, I would say. It smells very natural and it gives a lot of personality again. That won't be something extremely dark. So if you think of your favorite leather, like Tuscan leather from Tom Ford, it's not the vibe at all. It's something much more delicate and a bit more uplifting and very gentleman-like. Finally, one of my favorite categories is the Orientals. First Oriental is Coromandel. Voilà. Stella of the range, it smells very exotic again, but this one is an ambery oriental. So if you love amber fragrance and you enjoy this cocooning sexiness, sensuality of mysterious charm, love Coromandel. Coromandel, if you don't know what it is, Coromandel screen is a Chinese art, so in textile or can be wooden as well. And Coco Chanel was passionate with Coromandel screen. She had a lot and she used to travel with them. So can you imagine a lady traveling with massive Coromandel screen? Very meticulous art, and the fragrance itself is really meticulous as well. It's very contrasting. So when you smell it on your skin, it smells different from time to time, which is so nice. All Envelope by Frank Quincens. So very mystical kind of scent as well. And yeah, you've got this resinous tone with benzoin, so it's got everything that an ambery oriental fragrance should have in the elegance and classiness of Chanel. We've done 17 fragrances and there's still one that I need to talk. The surprise by the end is called Le Lion de Chanel, and this is the new creation of Chanel that is launched only in some countries for now. Talk about the ingredient for this one, because I will wait until it's launched in the UK to properly talk about it. It's only launched in some countries that are very lucky. Anyway, that's it. So I hope it did help you to categorize all the fragrance and understand more how this is working, and maybe it will help you to find new fragrance in a different category. I really enjoy talking with you about this, and I will see you very soon. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, leave me a little like if you will, and also for everyone that been watching some ads on my YouTube account, thank you so much. It gave me a little tip and it's always really nice, appreciated. So for the other one, the link is down below. You're not forced to do it, but if you do it, I love you. Okay, I will see you very soon. Bye now.